talks have been talking about SDGs, the UN Sustainable Development Goals, right? I'll focus on one aspect, that is life on land. Number 15 on the SDG is life on land, okay? And next is protect, restore, promote sustainable use of terrestrial ecosystems, sustainable forests, manage forests, combat desertification, halt and reverse land degradation, and halt biodiversity. Next, please. There's a Chinese saying that when one talks of the future, the devil laughs. When we talk about sustainable development, talk about the future, who knows about the future?
God,
exactly. So the devil laughs. Every time I give this talk, the devil laughs. Actually, yeah, you're laughing. Salleh, stop talking. Only God knows. But nevertheless, we are scientists, as Ahmad said, Prof. Ahmad said. Science, look at science. Based on science, we discuss things. Next, please. The global problems, as I see today, population growth, climate change, loss of biodiversity, and desertification. Thank God we don't have issues of desertification here. But if you go to Africa, you go to parts of Asia, desertification is a huge problem. Next, please. Population growth. My father had three wives. My late father. This is a lot of four. Not a one time love. But I have 15
children.
That's way too many. Thank God I only have three, so I don't contribute to overpopulation. But if you look at this graph, the population is going, is projected to increase to 11 billion. You have to build five more oxys. Next, please. 1 million, this is at the moment 6.7 million. 1 million people are illiterate. They can read. 2 billion have no electricity. 3 billion have no sanitation. And 4 billion, my dear friends, half have never heard the telephone ring. So consider yourself, my dear, as one of the lucky people. I'm one of the lucky people. Consider yourself as one of the luckiest people on earth. Because you have all this. Next, please. So don't miss. Poverty. I've seen poverty. I've been to Bangladesh. I've been to Africa. Go to India, the moment you step up, beggars come up to you. In the hearts, rule number one, don't give. Not that you don't want to give, but you give anything, you'll be surrounded by poverty. Yet India is one of the richest countries in the world. Next, please. Desertification, Africa, Asia, encroaching deserts. And deserts are eating into agricultural lands all over. What are the causes of desertification? Many. Next, please. Is climate change one of the causes? Yes. But the others, mismanagement of land, misuse of land. Next, please. In 1962, Michael Parsons, have you heard of her? Look at the book. Silent Spring. She was the first to raise a flag on the environment in 1962, before you were born again. She was the first. And she was looking at pesticides. She was talking about the dangers of pesticides, using pesticides in agriculture, the impact of pesticides, and how pesticides are toxic, poisonous. But now biodegradable pesticides, etc. She was the first. Next, two. Next, please. In 2006, Algo. Who was he? Who's Algo? Yes. Okay, la. I'll give you a book for that. The book is without my signature. My signature is not like 1 minute. Algo. You read the book and then give interest. There's a movie here. Talks about climate change and the impacts of climate change. Next, please. I've been to Antarctica 4 times. And I've been to Antarctica once. Although I didn't meet this young man there, this polar bear. But I met and seen polar bears. Next question. Are there polar bears in Antarctica?
No.
Who was the first answer? You got a book yet? No. Besides polar bears, what's the difference between Antarctica and Arctic? Why am I important? But we are all different. security against pest diseases. Next is the variety of life forms, the ecological roles that they perform, plus the genetic diversity. And now people who have genetic study of genetics know genetic diversity. Unfortunately, people look at the genes, they don't know how to look. They actually look at the actual plant or the animal look like. Right? So focus under the microscope. No. Let's see what the life. Wilcox is a famous biologist. Next, please. Next. Not just that save species for such a study, describing the role of species, the way of life, but more how they can contribute to the well-being. Right. I'm just telling our friends, you Google on YouTube, I didn't have time to show it. What was that? The Queen of Trees. Google the Queen of Trees. It's a 45-minute movie. One of the best videos I've seen. Thus, the interdependence between one element of the ecosystem and another. The queen of trees. Old man forgets her. Forgive me. I'm the oldest among all of us here. So I can take credit for that. Use as an excuse often. Next, please. The first conservation action. By whom? No one? Two by two, two by two. If you did not do that, you will not have. If you believe in it, if you don't believe in it, the others, there is other hypothesis. Next, please. But now there's an international awakening. Who knows what IUCN stands for? Google. And what does UNEP stand for? What does EA stand for? Yes. United Nations Environment Program, International Union of Conservation Nature, and I think the name is pronounced. The US Summit 1992, the United Nations Conference. Convention of Biodiversity, UNDP, GF, all addressing towards conserving biodiversity, all funding activity programs on biodiversity. Next, please. How many of you heard of Sungai Buloh? About the Damansara? The Sungai Buloh Forest Reserve is the oldest forest reserve in this country. We did a study on Singapore Forest Reserve using EF funding to map out the ecosystem of Singapore. Why I raise that is that we have in this country areas which are danger. You know what's in, what the Damansara Forest is? Anybody can tell me where it is? You go to NTVE. First of all, you go up, first plant, you go down, and on the right you see forest. That's part of the first forest reserve in the country. So next time you go to plant, you pass it all, you go up, right? Like a valley, the road carved through the mountain. Then you go down here towards but the Damansara, Subang, right? That hill down, as you go down here, on the right, yes, have a look on the right. A beautiful forest. That is the first forest reserve in the country. And it is the first community managed forest in this country. If you go there, there's a trail called the Salleh Trail. Big sandboard there. In recognition of what I did. Oh, yeah. called a Salleh camp inside. Why I raised this? As I might say, I've been involved in conservation all my life. Because I'm concerned that if you don't fight for nature, who's going to fight for nature?
Exactly.
You and me. The trees cannot talk. The animals cannot talk. They cannot. Not in our language. So we have to fight for it. The policies are there. National Biodiversity Policy, 1998. The Biodiversity Biotechnical Council, chaired by none other than the Prime Minister himself. I have the interest. Species and plants declining in an alarming way. There's a tree called Combretta capus. I think first inventory when of the early incarnation or when early age, my early career. I spent 4 years being in and out forest. Measuring trees, would you believe it? Put a tape around it and measure it. See the height. And that contributed first national forest inventory in the country. Then we knew how much forest we have. But thanks to me, FEDA knows where the good lands are. So they took all the good lands. But that's not common policy. Now we have monitored the technology, but all the species disappear. And species disappearance is akin to burning your library books before your breakfast. The loss of biodiversity is akin to, or similar to, burning your library books before you have read them. Because how do you know what the wealth of biodiversity is? I always believe that the cure for cancer is in the forest. And there's a plant in Sarawak. Anybody know the plant? Well publicized a couple of years ago. And they work with the US, Japan, they can cure cancer. And they're working out, they're doing, what trials, Matt? Clinical trials. Telephylum is a Nyato species. In Sarawak. And the orang asris, the asal, as they call it. As far as I know, my first wife, and this is my second wife, but I married her with the approval of my first wife. Remember that? I didn't go to Hanyai, Bolong, and come back and then the duck. Do you want to do things properly? Do it properly. That was very third one, she said, no, I'm better, wrong. So, the other question is, have no record of cancer. As far as I know, my first wife worked in online hospital. But now they have. Because they're in contact with you and me. They eat McDonald's. They take fried chicken. They don't spend the herbs anymore. Next, please. You don't love that. King of fruits. You see, the durian is like eating dark cheese in the toilet. It smells like hell, but tastes like heaven. But just imagine a life without durians. Who don't like durian? What do you like? Thank God, the chicken is. But this biodiversity, and you know what that species is? What is that one? I should give a book to the first answer. Pulasan. What's the difference between pulasan and rambutan?
The hair is great.
Why do you call it pulasan? Yeah, you pulas. You pulas. You do do rambutan, you press it, twist. You can't do the rambutan, press and twist. The other difference is, one more difference, I'll give you a book for this again.
Oh.
What's it not?
What's it?
Yes.
People
are planting, I have a present tree.
Can you eat
the seed? The seed of pulasan
can be eaten.
Oh. It's like chestnut. Okay. You take the seed, you fry it, or you with an oil, and then you're better than chestnut. You cannot do that with the seed around that. Have you done something? After 1 month, you try it. If it's not, become amazing. Suddenly you like. But if not, you have to buy me a kilogram. Next, please. So this resurgence of organic food, spices. We are always dependent on Western medicine, including me. I had high blood pressure when I was 40. So my doctor prescribed high blood pressure pills. I said, Salleh, sorry, you have to take this for life. But once you start high blood pressure pills, you have to take it for life. So if you can avoid high blood pressure pills, please avoid it. There are other ways of doing it. What's the best way to have blood pressure?
Lower stress.
Huh? Lower stress, yes. Good point. One more?
Change of salt.
Huh? Yeah, change of salt.
Exercise.
It is.
Salt.
Salt.
Yeah. One more. I'm looking at that one
answer.
Yes. You can book already, man. Sit, go to the office, you sit in the helicopter, you go home, you sit in the bed, in the dining hall, you sit in the front computer. You don't exercise. That's why this is great. I try to exercise 3 times a week. Go to the gym, and I play squash. At my age, how old am I? Yes. You are a darling. No. Way above that.
70, 70, 80.
Close enough.
74.
70. I'm 78 this year. Oh. Not bad, huh? Squash. It's regular, but backstroke only. So we start with regular. Full exercise and don't overeat. Please. What's the most important thing in life?
How many species of trees are there in Malaysia?
say that? 2000. Okay, lah. It's before that, but I give to you. Yeah. This is a good book. Interesting. Sustaining Nature's Future. You're welcome. But there's so many species yet discovered. That is a wonder of the tropical forest. Every time we do an expedition, the next we're going to do an Imbab Canyon expedition. Tell me, where is Imbab Canyon? Imbab Canyon, where is it? Yes.
Sabah.
Sabah, correct. Yeah. We're going to do an Imbab Canyon. I'm the chairman of the expedition. Yeah. I'm coming now. challenges. Next, please. just tell you how many birds, how many fish number. Viruses, fungus, algae, animalia, contacta, huge variety of biodiversity. How many of you know of Chandavan Bhusan? What's the English name of that? The most delicious mushroom in the country.
Truffles.
Huh?
Truffles.
My dear, truffle is Europe, not the Malaysian. But you're right, it's as nice as truffle, but not as expensive as truffles. Chandavan, no, you don't have truffles in Malaysia. Chandavan Bhusan is the termite mushroom. It forms in the termite mound after a thunderstorm. Next time I must tell the story. And the challenge is, can you produce this artificially? It's expensive. I think 100 grams is about 25 ringgit. But you get it, they collect it in the oil palm states. But they use pesticides, insecticides, and all kinds. So you don't know what sort of, and fungus absorbs all this. So you may be eating, but you can produce this artificially. You couldn't make. The challenge with scientists, I told this on many occasions, to produce the artificial genomics. It's similar to that, but this is not. This is not genomics. Malaysia, 112 megadiverse, 20,000 species of plants, 20,000 species recorded, how many more unrecorded? Next please. That's fungi, marine fish, freshwater fish. Keep all these figures in mind because I'm going to ask you questions about this. Next please. Platin, the high plants, highly threatened. Next is endangered species. Question: is the Sumatran rhino threat available? I saw one many years ago in the first inventory in the 60s. Of course, you can see in the zoo still. That is the tapir. Okay. Can Muslims eat tapir? with the Lord. Says of release. What is that runtong? Liver therapy. The river therapies are also being threatened because the locals eat the eggs. So rule number one, don't eat turtle eggs. Please. Next, please. 1960s, 10,000 came shot in Ghana. Now, don't. I'll give you a book. Raise up your hand against it. What is the main cause of the disappearance of leatherbacks from Brazil? Can I answer? Eating the eggs is one. Other than that? Plastic. Yeah, they do that. Yes. The oil and gas up on the coast are lighted at night. And so they attracted the redback turtle to them rather than the shore. And once there, they get entangled in fishermen's net and they die. So many records of redback turtles were entangled in fishermen's net or distracted by the lights of derricks, oil derricks. Okay. And, so, one, don't eat the race. Two, join the protection. Next, please. Sumatra rhinoceros. Very common. Four. What's the difference between Sumatran rhinoceros, one main difference, and the African rhinoceros?
The size.
Size, yes. What? What's the difference? Yeah, what's the difference? No. Yes. One and two. Which is one, which is two? Yes, two. The African rhinoceros have two horns. Well, you got one, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, same one book. Next, please. Remember this stuff. You go to the zoo, you find them flying around now. You go down MR2, find them flying. But it's an endangered species. And MNS in the program in Queensland on Nature Park, trying to breed them. Cage. But now the MNS project was not very successful because of the funds. And we got the pest destroying the, what call it, the cage. By the time in the paddy fields, I'm sure I might remember saying this. Next, please. Success story of the Rambutan's meditation centers in Sabah. Visit them, if you go to Sabah, visit them. It's a beautiful area. Go to the Sun Bay as well, the center as well. Next, please. Sabah is a beautiful country in terms of wildlife. Protected areas. Where is that? White. Pinnacles, yeah. Where is that?
Sarawak.
Right. Not that side. You can find. You get a book? I have not been there myself, but it's not very easy accessible. So I've been to Mulu. 64 to 94 parks are the national state parks, wildlife reserve, wildlife sanctuary, nature reserve. we are not as a definition. Next, this is the same as the first one. See, development, what it should and it should not be. The structure is parts of the political system, economic, social laws, laws of habitat. Next, this. The problem is when they are lost, you don't hear it. You don't really know when it's conflicting ecosystem for instance. Mention this the capture in the land development. Next please. Millions of species depend on human survival as much as we depend on them. So remember that. Next please. So we get deforestation continues on. The poor dogs will have to land up. Next please. Who trained the dog? Economic value is huge. Pharmaceuticals, we mentioned biofiber, new composites, new adhesives, biomimicry trees, something is a part of the effort. Biofuel, ecotourism, water, nature services, too many. Carbon sequestration is the main thing now. This damage. Social and static values, next. Too many. Don't forget, in the urban areas, we still have biodiversity. Next. The impact of disturbance is just not loss of it, but genetic resource, loss of potential economic resource, loss of links to nature's balance. I mentioned just now, green of trees. Next, please. Google that. Have a look. Unfortunately, we have not. Taxonomies are a dying breed. People are not interested in taxonomy. They're not glamorous. We have yet to have a natural history museum, although some are. Great academic science and trying to push for setting up a national history museum in this country for many years. Next, please. Challenges to convince decision makers to manage the conservators and national history museum. Next, please. These are some of the solutions that can have been done. We've got to manage what we have as best as possible. Next, please. And climate change has very serious impacts on biodiversity. The early flowering. See, for durians to flower, I'm told, that the diurnal temperature within the night time and the daytime. The diurnal difference in temperature must be a minimum of 2 degrees centigrade. If the diurnal temperature difference is less than that, the bud becomes a leaf bud, not a flower bud. So if climate change does happen, it may affect endurance, don't it? The ignorant. There goes my hypothesis. Plus, increase the factor. Mosquitoes. Other factors. Next, please. Coral bleaching. So we're going to change our anthropocentric ways towards ecocentric. Anthropocentric is self. We. was ecocentric. Next. We have technologies, adaptations, etc. So Malaysia is a signatory of the Convention on Biodiversity. Next. So my personal recommendations are these. You must insist on a state and parliament representatives to spell out the stand on environmental and conservation. Can you do that for G14? I don't think they haven't looked at environment. All the manifestos, nothing on the environment. Revise resource allocation to urgent areas where they are threatened and endangered. Strengthen our protection of our parks. Taman Negara is there since 1939. But the department, the management department, it is small and ineffective and poaching is rampant. Establish a national history museum. We have yet to have one. We have developed human resources, people who are passionate for the environment. And I suggest that we develop a forest development fund. Of course, last but not least, join MNS. How many of you are members of MNS? Not a single one. Shame. It's the oldest NGO in the country. Formed in 1940, amongst this MNS and SMN. Sorry about my name, we were born the same year. We born 1940, I was born 1942. So we destined to be together. I was president for 30 years. We have branch in every state. We have 5,000 members in the country. And 2020 will be 80 years old, and we have a major program. So join MNS, just Google. Just 50 ringgit a year. Cheap. You go to Pasar Malam, you spend 100 ringgit. Minimum. 50 ringgit to help conserve nature. Please, will you support me in that? Will you support me in that? No, next, please. So I've done this all my life. I created Prim, I created Narongpin, I created Bloom. And now I'm chairman of Friends of Big Terra, which is. Oh, I need that, more than that. She can guarantee that. But we need more people to join me in conserving nature. Because they cannot talk, they cannot reflect. We have to do that. There's so many things in my life that I've done. Not that I'm boasting, but one time when Tun Mahathir was Mr. One corporate giant wanted to build a linear city over Gombak River. Can you just imagine what will happen to Gombak River? People, just imagine you have a linear city over Thames. And the British go after you will kill you. Thank God, made an objection and PM agreed. Then someone wanted to build a road to the foot of Taman to Gruntahan. So why is too far to walk? That's it. You can't do that. But when you open access, remember the poachers are coming. Who's going to control the poachers? And to go to Taman Negara, I went to climb. Hike la! Drive there. And many more. I'm giving a set of books to the library.